Hi, welcome to the Old Tatter Flag. My name is Julie Thomas, and along with my mother, we operate this little business. The way it started was a few years ago, I did a painting, and my mother asked me if I could turn it into a rug hooking design, and I said sure, and that's how it all took off. For example, I did this Santa painting last year. I then turned it into a rug hooking pattern, which she did. Cover myself up. Then turned it into a miniature, which is done with punch needle, which is punching with thread. And then I turned it into a wool applique pattern. All three mediums, punch needle, rug hooking, and wool applique, are available in many designs at our website, www.theoldtatterflag.com. Over the next few days, we hope to introduce several tutorial videos. The first one will be rug hooking 101. Thanks.
Yep. Basic rug hooking 101. You need wool, you need a pattern, you need a hook, you need a frame, you need something to cut the wool with. This is a quarter yard of wool. You cut it down into strips. You either cut it with your scissors, your rotary cutter, or your cutter here. I'm going to cut the wool right up to the edge. I'm going to cut it. There's your strips that you will use. I'm going to take your, I take this. This is your pattern. I want it to fit as tight as it can. That's good. This is how you're going to start if you're doing it with a frame. Now I need to pick a hook. This is an inexpensive sponge handle, good for arthritic. This is one that's been designed for us, very nice. Some people like to use this type. Some people like this one. This happens to be mine and it's my favorite. It's bent. It's not a large hook, but it's what I work with no matter what the cut of wool. Some people will hold it like this. I hold it like a pencil, like this. That's your preferences. Some people use an embroidery hoop. That's your personal preference. You have to have one that doesn't slip because you really need to hold this tight and the fabric needs to be really tight. I prefer this frame. It's 20 years old. It works wonderful for me. Sits on my lap, it's good. Here at the Old Tattered Flag, we sell beginner kits, which come all cut, come in a package like this. They're simple, it teaches you the basics, and once you've learned the basics, you can go from a small item like this to a large item. This here is the star. This is what it looks like finished. This is how you're going to begin. Got it. I'm left-handed. I start this way. If you're right-handed, you're going to start this way. Being left, going here. I have this right like this. I'm putting it underneath and touching the material. So I'm feeling the hook through the material. I'm pulling it up, adjusting it to where I like it. I'm going down down, down. What I'm trying to do is bring all my loops up so that they're even. And as I'm doing this on the top, what's happening down at the bottom is I'm putting my hook down. I'm looping it around the wool. As you can see, my fingers are trying to keep it so that I do not turn the wool. I'm hooking, I'm looping, I'm continuing. I'm trying to stay in the line or on the line. I don't want to go out of the line because that's going to give me my shape. I turn my frame when I need to adjust. I'm coming up. I can feel that I'm coming to the end of the strand of wool. Okay, see right there? I think I went out too far, so I'm pulling it out. I'm bringing it in there so that I'm more in line. Hi, Max.
You never know what you'll get here. There's three dogs who rule the roost.
There's my last loop. I always want to have my loops up the end of it. There's the end one.
The ends.
There's the ends. Okay, because I'm a little close, I'm going to...
Max can't get up, apparently. Max, you all right?
Okay. I've adjusted so that I'm a little bit lower, but I still want to keep it very tight. I'm taking another strand of wool. I'm taking the end. I'm bringing it right in to where this last one was. I'm bringing it through the same hole. Coming up. Doing this again. Doing this again. Doing this again. Now I want to cut this. Unfortunately, my scissors are over there.
Hold on, Mom. I'll get those for you. Hold on, people. Isn't this suitcase of wool just lovely? Going back over here, handing Mom her scissors. You know what? We've tried making this video being straight-faced and straight-laced, and we can't do it. You just gotta be who you are.
You always have little nubs like this. Save them. Future, I'll tell you why you want to save them. But you need something to put them in.
A snippet bowl. A nice snippet bowl.
I've turned my material. I've cut here so it's sharp. I'm back again. I'm coming into the same hole. I'm coming down now. I want to come down. And if you notice my hook, my end of my hook is facing away from me. That's very important so you don't twist your wool.
No twisted wool underneath. If Mom sees twisted wool, she'll make her students pull it out.
I go berserk.
She's a beast.
Okay, now there I thought I came too far up again. I want to come make sure I'm in the line. I don't want to go out of the line here. I feel I'm coming to the end of this strip of wool again. I want to make sure I pull it up. Please, ladies, do not pull a big line because you waste a lot of wool. You want to use your wool as economically as possible.
Meaning, if you get to the end here of your tip, I can't see my finger. If you get to the tip here and you pull your strip up and you've got a good segment of wool left, save it and use it because
start.
We put certain amounts of wool in your kits, and let's face it, wool's expensive. So you don't want to have to buy more wool because you have lots of big hunks of wool left over.
All right, I'm going back into the same hole where the last one was, bringing it up. I don't want to go outside again, so I'm staying inside, hook is away from me.
Now, when you're hooking also, you don't start with the background, right, Mom? A lot of people say, where do you start? You always start with your subject matter.
Your center item, usually. This is easy because there's only two objects that you're going to hook. I've cut that. I'm cutting this. I tend to be anal about this. Some people leave them till the end, but I am anal. All right. What I want to do now is show you the back. So you're pretty. It's looping, looping, looping. And you, what is the most important thing is to just try to have your loops level. I'm going over to this side now. If I did this, put it in, and I came and I did one loop, and I did one loop, and then for some reason this loop was really high, and I did this and this, all I have to do is take those out and bring it down. If I had one that was really short, and I didn't want to take it out, you can take your hook, put it in, and just very gently pull it up. Now when I get to this corner...
Max, are you getting all this? Max?
I turn my frame.
Sorry. There's another email. I'm going to pull away now, and then what we're going to do is we're going to assume that the star's all hooked, and we're going to start with the other color, which would be the background.
I want to show you how to start your outside. As you can see, there's a line here, and if you feel uncomfortable that you can't see where the holes are in the line, I always go one below so I can see. And if you can see, this is what I'm trying to do. I want to make sure that this is square. So I'm going to follow all those holes right across.
So you always do the outside frame first?
I always frame it first before I start anything else because I want to make sure that it's squared.
And by squared, she means even. Monk's cloth, linen, all of your backing fabrics have a tendency to stretch a lot. I'm the one who draws the patterns, so I can tell you it's very important to have your outside frame always on an even line, meaning you're going to go evenly across the dots. If I was to just draw a straight line and it wasn't even, your design would be
off.
Off, yeah. So now Mom's framing it in. I'm going to let her continue hooking and we'll come back in a minute.